Assalamualaikum and hi. Hari ini 21 Januari 2021, hari ke-9 PKP 2.0.
Dalam video kali ini saya nak share berkenaan dengan laptop. So baru-baru ni selepas habis PKP dalam bulan berapa bulan 10, bulan 11 kot. So I decided to go to Loyad untuk beli laptop for my daughter and also my son.
I think the online schooling ni dia akan berterusan for quite some times. And I hope by getting this laptop for both of them, it will help them to apa dalam study orang lah.
Sebelum tu dah pergi dekat kedai-kedai lain nak survey second hand laptop atau used laptop. Cuma semua harga below 1000, tapi the specs tu I don't really like it. Tak menepati cita rasa yang saya nak. Saya tak ada nak check the latest processor apa semua, because you want below 1000 ringgit untuk a used laptop. Tapi basically at least I need a decent specs lah. And also another criteria yang saya tengok untuk use laptop ni is condition of the laptop tu itself. I ada tengok laptop yang brand macam-macam lah, HP apa semua, 15 inch, besar, tapi the condition tu macam nampak sangat macam dah used condition. So at that time I tengok dekat Subang, ada satu kedai dekat Subang tu. So saya macam in between lah, nak beli ke tak nak beli, nak beli ke tak nak beli. So I decided I need to go to Loyad first and survey kat sana lah. At least dekat Loyad ada lagi banyak options kan. So I went to Loyad. Cari-cari-cari. And then ada jumpa satu kedai ni, I can't remember dekat tingkat berapa laptop, tingkat 3 ke tingkat 4 lah laptop, I tak ingat. So ada satu kedai ni yang the salesman tu macam macam orang-orang Pakistan macam tu lah kot. So ada satu I tengok Lenovo ThinkPad. This is the one yang I pegang sekarang ni, Lenovo ThinkPad. I think ni model tahun 2012 kot, X230. So as you know, Lenovo ThinkPad ni is a flagship model daripada Lenovo, and the brand dia memang terkenal dengan durability, ketahanan. And bila I tengok the specs and the condition is quite good lagi. See? Tapi yang ni yang Jepun punya model. So sebab tu you nampak keyboard, ada keyboard apa yang tulisan Jepun tu. So bila I tengok, I inspect balik, cakap yeah, this is a good condition. This is still in good condition. In terms of spec, processor dia pakai i5, if I'm not mistaken, second or third generation. At that time, the spec, the standard spec yang dia datang, 4GB of RAM dengan 256 SATA hard drive. I've decided to upgrade the hard drive to SSD, 128 SSD drive. And then RAM upgrade to 8GB. And the good thing is there is a memory card punya slot dekat sini, where you can put your memory card to as an expandable storage lah. So in this case, I ada beli yang SanDisk punya memory card 128GB. Jadi nak tambah lah, jadi so in total dia 256GB lah. So far so good in terms of battery life. I think dia boleh tahan dalam 2 to 3 hours lah. I tak expect lama sangat because this is a used notebook. Cuma what I really satisfied is the condition of the notebook lah. Nampak macam baru, and it's just nice for my kids to use it. Still below 1000 ringgit. And apa lagi Cuma the keyboard tu, layout of the keyboard tu dia ikut Japan punya layout. So kena map dengan US punya layout, agak tricky sikit lah. The nice thing about this dia notebook ni, dia tak ada keyboard, dia tak ada lampu, dia tak ada backlit keyboard, tapi dia ada lampu. Dia ada lampu, tengok disebabkan dia tak ada keyboard, dia tak ada lampu. So what they did, they put an LED light dekat atas ni, sebelah kamera ni. So if I activate it, nampak there is a light there. So ada lampu lah, nak type malam-malam nampak lah. So which is okay lah. So far so good experience. I installed Windows 10 of Microsoft Office 365. Sekat my son nak guna untuk class, online class, Google Meet apa semua tak ada isu. I think kalau untuk editing video tu tak sesuai lah, because processor lama kan, mungkin ada issue in terms of performance. But I tak pernah try untuk install lagi. I think it's a good investment untuk my son punya kelas online, my daughter punya kelas online. And I would love to recommend this, cuma I tahu sekarang macam mana nak pergi Dawiyat kan. So one thing kalau nak beli laptop ni, make sure processor tu bukan yang lama sangat. Second, RAM tu at least 8GB lah, 8GB ya. And third, I think this is also contribute to the performance, is the hard disk. Make sure you guna SSD drive, sebab SSD drive ni dia lagi laju compared to SATA. So at least kalau pakai SSD tu, dia akan compensate the performance of the CPU yang agak lama tu. Kalau nak lagi better, you upgrade the RAM up to 60GB. And think this one boleh support up to 60GB kot. All in all, good investment, value for money. Boleh carilah. For me, kalau I nak beli second hand notebook ni, I prefer to go to the physical store so that I can really inspect the notebook, nak tengok the condition of the notebook apa semua lah. Kalau ikutkan online banyak je, tapi sometimes you tak dapat tengok the actual notebook tu kan. Kalau baru tu lain lah. Itu saja for this video. See you when I see you. Thank you.